tensions in the South China Sea have been escalating, but ASEAN nations, say for Vietnam, have been deafeningly silent, if not neutral for the matter. What novel strategies can the ASEAN adopt in order to prevent further Chinese aggression in the South China Sea? What was the intention of raising maritime tensions at the ASEAN-China summit when countries usually take it up in other forums like the EAS or the NDA-ARF?
Well, we take every opportunity that we can, again, to make the Philippine position clear. Our intent really is, at this point, what we are doing is trying to manage the situation. All of us who have been working on this problem for a while, I have come to the conclusion there's no silver bullet here that will solve the problems immediately. So we have to just manage it so that there's no conflict, that we do not, it does not erupt into a hotter confrontation than it already is. So what we in the Philippines' approach to maintaining and to protecting our sovereignty is to keep a presence. Basta't meron tayong barko doon, meron tayong mangingisda, meron tayong presence doon sa bawat lugar. Ngayon, kung meron mga mangyayari na ini-intimidate yung ating mga fishermen o hinaharang yung ating mga barko, yung mga coast guard, we will just have to deal with it. But nonetheless, whatever happens, we will maintain that presence. Because it is important that to show the world and our people that we are in the business of protecting our sovereignty. We are in the business of maintaining of protecting our territorial imperatives. We are insisting on exercising our sovereign rights.
Sir, it was the Philippines that first proposed the creation of a code of conduct in the South China Sea. When we couldn't get that, Philippines pushed for the adoption of a declaration of conduct in 2002, and you know, we're hosting the ASEAN in 2026. Will we push for the conclusion of the COC?
Every single day we push for the conclusion of COC, because then that will provide the basis that will, I'm sure that will come when the time comes, when if and when we have that COC, then it will lay down the rules for everyone to follow. And it will stabilize the situation. That's why it is so important. That's why I don't want to make it a small matter that we push. We really push. In fact, in almost every one of my interventions here at this ASEAN summit, we mentioned that and say that the solution for now to this is, well, no, not for now. The solution in the end will be to have a COC, and we are always pushing for it too. We have to accelerate the negotiations. We have to define our terms already as quickly as possible so we can talk about the issues. That's a very important part of our argument.
Sir, last question, sir. So with that in mind, how do you think the ASEAN should accelerate those talks? You've pushed it in your interventions. How do you think the other ASEAN member countries could accelerate?
I think the onus is now on China to accelerate those talks. ASEAN has been waiting for a long time.
That's about it, Mr. President.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. Maraming salamat. Thank you.